Now, how often do you consider the need for critically important information in farming and ultimately investment in agriculture? Well, for many Ugandans, that is something that rarely comes by. The new Minister for Agriculture, Animal Industry and Fisheries, Frank Tumwebaze, has hit the ground running, asking news and information outlets to disseminate what he described as useful information to farmers to enable them to make informed decisions before they can venture into any particular farming activity. The minister made the remarks while meeting Vision Group top management, headed by the Managing Director and Chief Executive Officer, Don Wanyama.
Thank you so much.
Minister Frank Tumwebaze and the Ministry Permanent Secretary Pius Wakabi Kasaija today paid a courtesy visit to Vision Group to meet its top management. These were welcomed by the Editor-in-Chief, Barbara Kaija, who led them to the Managing Director's office. After the meeting, Vision Group Managing Director Don Wanyama revealed that their meeting was aimed at discussing a possible partnership between the Ministry of Agriculture and the Vision Group that will lead to improvement of the agriculture sector.
Of undertakings, we have previously worked with the ministry on some of these, and so we thought that re-energizing this conversation at this point, as you as the new minister and continuing with your technical team, would be a good idea. But also we are in a bit of a new normal now because of the pandemic. There are things that we think we can do differently away from the usual. So we used to have, for example, farmers expos physically in the stadium, Nambole and others. But given the restrictions we are having, and which might be here for a long time, we are thinking that there are other ways in which we can still continue engaging audiences.
The Vision Group has made a number of interventions to improve agriculture in the country. Among them is the Harvest Money Project. However, Don Wanyama explains that more is yet to be done to ensure that Ugandans adopt a positive attitude towards agriculture.
But in a different way. So these are some of the ideas we are going to pose to you and your team, and then also listen to you, and then we see how we can proceed. But in principle, Honorable Minister, that is it. So
Wakabi Pius Kasaija, the Ministry of Agriculture Permanent Secretary, explains that news outlets play a crucial role in the development of a sector, including agriculture.
First being the PR, which you know. The second being the knowledge. Because with our farmers, they need a lot of knowledge. And as you are aware, our extension system is not yet equipped to the level that it can provide this knowledge to the people the way we should. But I know through media, we can be able to give the farmers the knowledge and educate them on whatever we need to do. We consider agriculture as a business and should be treated as a business. And it's through knowledge that farmers will be able to be transformed from being subsistence farmers to commercial farmers.
Really, let's use the media to influence of our farmers. You see, and remember, that's what the president says, wake up the 3 million people. If we don't wake them up, now we'll continue to give them inputs. They'll still go to waste. So we can work with you on making sure that agriculture statistics are validated. Yes, if we say diet has increased by this to this, we need to know where is the bulk of the milk coming from. So, and on that one, we haven't concretized as the ministry. Hopefully, when the lockdown is up, maybe September or October, God willing, we shall reach out and carry sub-regional farmer dialogues.
Tumwebaze suggested that the new vision adopts farming profiles in their publications and news items to ensure that farmers get the right information about farming.
Or sub-regional profiles. If it is Ankole, what is their food crop or crops? What are the cash crops that earn them money? There is Matoke now, the prices are hitting their lowest. What do we need to do? What are the other supplementary ones? So, Maif, we must have a clear farming profile, and we believe New Vision can be a pattern in this. Yes, that if I am in Western Nile, I should know. Western Nile has 8 districts. The stable food crops are this and this. The cash crops are this and this. So if NADS is to intervene in Western Nile, they must do this and this. So that our interventions are driven by the demands of the actual people.
And take a note of the interests of the ministry, both from the PS and yourself, Honorable Minister. We agree in terms of going forward that we shall need to sort out the MOU things. I didn't have that brief, I'll need to know why. But in principle, we agree that we should expedite it and get it done. Then, thanks for the guidance on extension through media.